The best games of the year is a popular topic for obvious reasons, and it's even fun to talk about the worst. But a topic that goes unexplored far too often are the games that were great but for one reason or another didn't get a whole lot of traction. Often, these games end up building good fan bases over time, despite missing out on their time in the spotlight. With that, here is our list of the 10 best sleeper hits of 2020. Number 10, Maneater. While a game about playing a shark and eating people in various different situations might not be everybody's bag, in fact, it might only really appeal to a small subset of gamers generally, Maneater goes out of its way to be a far more deep and goal-oriented experience than most might assume when looking at its core gameplay loop. While that loop is still generally pretty simple and doesn't throw a whole lot of variation at you throughout its fairly short campaign, the degree to which it does develop its handful of ideas do add up to a rather fun experience, as ridiculous as it is. Maneater will probably never go down as a classic of its time, but that does not stop it from standing out amongst the plethora of action-adventure games that we have access to today and taking a bite out of your expectations. Number 9, 13 Sentinels. Much like VanillaWare's previous games, the absolutely gorgeous art style of 13 Sentinels is more than enough reason for you to at least take a look at it and see if it's something you might enjoy. It's definitely a more passive experience than Dragon's Crown or Odin's Fear, as its gameplay almost teeters into visual novel territory for much of its runtime. But that slower-paced development is also broken up by a deliberately methodical battle system that burns quite slow but is all the more engaging for it. It might take some time before 13 Sentinels' appeal is ever really fully realized. But the game is without a doubt yet another fantastic outing from VanillaWare that complements its wonderful storybook art style with engaging gameplay and a story that is more than worth your time. Number 8, Cloudpunk. Our review of Cloudpunk wasn't exactly overflowing with compliments. It's not particularly well optimized on consoles, and it doesn't do quite as much with its intriguing world as it perhaps should've. But that doesn't stop Cloudpunk from being an interesting romp with characters, story threads, and impactful choices that are all likely to exceed your expectations, at least in terms of their impact on you most of the time. Kind of like 13 Sentinels, Cloudpunk is a bit of a slow burn, but it also rewards your dedication by showing you deeper and deeper layers of the characters and the world in which it exists. It's not the kind of game that stands out quickly or grabs a lot of attention at face value, but given that there is so much good underneath the surface of Cloudpunk, I would not be surprised if its fan base continued to grow for years to come. Number 7, Sakuna of Rice and Ruin. The world just plain needs more games like Sakuna of Rice and Ruin. It's a very straightforward side-scrolling platformer action game that doesn't bite off more than it can chew with its story or its gameplay. And as a result, it executes its core tenets extremely well and delivers something quite special for fans of the genre. If this game looks like something that you would be into, odds are you will enjoy it. Definitely give it a shot. Number 6, Spiritfarer. Spiritfarer is a game that is unlike most others, as it really drills down on the idea of death in a productive way, and also explores the trials and tribulations associated with making sure that the life you led was meaningful. It basically centers around finding other spirits who are lost and helping them find their way over to the next phase by helping them with their various needs in very story-driven quests. It's a very low-key adventure, but it has some intensely heartwarming moments, and of course, as you can see, the wonderful art style makes it all the more inviting. And it's driven home with an excellent, subtle soundtrack that gives important moments the gravity they deserve while also providing a calmly emotional tone for everything else. Number 5, Desperados 3. 2020, like most years, had its share of top-down strategic games that reward patience and planning. But Desperados 3 was arguably the best game in this variety from the year. It's a Western with stealth that's rewarding, challenging, and at times downright complicated. But because of that, it's a stealth game for fans of stealth games, through and through. If it weren't for the Western aesthetic oozing out from every corner, you could certainly get some original Metal Gear Solid vibes. But as it stands, it's very much its own thing, and certainly worth a try for those it's most clearly aimed at. Number 4. Neon Abyss. Neon Abyss is a game that was fairly well advertised, but as soon as it came out, quickly got overshadowed by many bigger games that came out around the same time. Nevertheless, it's an extremely high-octane shoot-'em-up mess of neon lights and retro carnage that cannot be ignored for fans of that sort of thing. Number 3. Hotshot Racing. For every person that says the arcade racing genre is dead, I point them in the direction of games like Hotshot Racing, that not only revived the genre with expertise in and appreciation for that style, but also brings some interesting ideas to it that previously hadn't really existed in the older games that inspired it. Great racing, a steady sense of progression, and a few extra modes to keep things interesting are the main reasons why you should definitely give this game a shot. While the bigger budget racing games of 2020 like Dirt 5 and Project Cars 3 have definitely overshadowed games like Hotshot Racing, that doesn't mean you shouldn't dig a little deeper until you find the gold nugget that is this game. Number 2. Streets of Rage 4. Very few games have ever flown under the mainstream radar less deservedly than Streets of Rage 4. It takes basically everything the previous three Streets of Rage games did and very conservatively improves upon them in subtle ways to make arguably the best game in the series and thus one of the best beat-em-ups of all time. The Saturday morning cartoon art style might be hit or miss depending on your taste, but it's done so well that it's hard to be distracted by it for very long. Excellent gameplay, a genuine affection for the source material, and some modern tweaks all make Streets of Rage 4 an excellent experience that will likely build in popularity for years to come. Number 1. Until You Fall. As the modern VR world continues to mature, we're really starting to see it come into its own with a steadier stream of excellent games. Until You Fall might be 2020's best example of the medium from the entire year and certainly has earned its spot in your library with its precise swordplay and visually striking art style. A reasonably deep RPG system and a good variety of weapons serve as icing on the cake for this title, and it's without a doubt one of the biggest sleeper hits of the year. That's it for this video. If you enjoyed and would like to see more, feel free to hit that subscribe button and hit the notification bell to ensure you'll be notified when new videos go up.